Good morning, friends. I want to talk to you guys today about a waterlogged pressure tank and short cycling pressure switches and what that might be meaning and why that's a problem. Let's get into it. So, you have a well system, right? Every house that's on private water is going to have one because you got to have drinking water somewhere, right? So you're going to have the well outside and then you're going to have the water line that comes in. Well, where do you put that water? How do you pressurize it, right? That's where the well tank comes into play. The pressure tank or the well tank is going to be a large blue thing, right? Sometimes they're gray, sometimes they're yellow. It depends on who makes it, but almost everybody makes them blue. It's going to be top part air, bottom part water, and there's going to be a little bladder in between. The pump in the well will push the water up into the house, into that pressure switch or pressure tank, and then that will pneumatically push the water through the rest of the home, right? We've covered this topic before. How that works is there's going to be a little thing called a pressure switch. That switch is a little gray box. Sometimes they're black, but almost every single time they're gray boxes. That switch is going to turn on and turn off on a certain pressure setting, right? Generally, it'll be a 20-point swing, right? Usually, you'll see a 20-40 switch, 30-50 switch, or a 40-60 switch. So when the air pressure in that pressure tank drops to 40 PSI, for sake of argument, the switch will engage, the pump will pump and compress that air to 60 PSI, and then the switch will disengage. Now, what happens with a short cycle? When you have a pressure tank, right, you're going to want to make sure that you have it sized appropriately for the pump that you have in the ground. Now, that appropriate sizing should put you roughly around 60 seconds. As long as you're above 30, you're okay. Anything beyond 60 is fine, right? What'll burn up a well pump is not necessarily the runtime. That does put excessive wear and tear on the motor and on the impellers. However, it's the on-off, right? So when you're short cycling, you're not giving the pump enough runtime to cool down, right? The water is actually the coolant. There's no other coolant that you're adding to the well. There's nothing goofy that you're putting in the water to cool the well pump, but the water itself. Groundwater's got a nice cool temperature to begin with. So the longer you let that thing run, the more it can dissipate that heat, right? So if you've got a 60 second run time, that should mean that your pump should function as intended, and you should, in theory, get roughly 10 to 15 years on it. Now, of course, there's more different variables that cause a well pump not to work, right? Let's just say you have a super deep well with a really low yield and you're burning through that reserve. Well, if the pump's working harder to get the water up and into the house, of course it's going to last a shorter lifespan. Same thing if your well's a football field away from the home. Yeah, that pump's got to work harder to get the water to your house, so it will not get as long of a lifespan. So, short cycle. Less than 30 seconds, right? So if you have that happen, how do you as a homeowner know that we have a short cycle? The most common way that you'll see it is if you're walking around in your house and somebody's showering, doing laundry, or something else is going on, you'll hear click, 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 and it'll be every 5 to 10 seconds, give or take. That's not good, right? That's a problem. If you start to notice that it's like 20 seconds, 25 seconds, most times that's usually the tank itself's undersized, right? So if somebody slaps in a 20-gallon tank and you got a 15-gallon per minute discharge, that's a little too small for that discharge rate, right? So that's a whole different topic for a whole different world. So you hear that clicking sound while you're running the sink, right? That's pretty hard for you to see unless you just happen to be in the right spot at the right time. What most homeowners will see generally is going to be a pulsation in the water. The water will increase in speed, decrease in speed, increase in speed, decrease in speed. Usually it'll put you around 5 or 10 seconds, right? So if that's happening, it's not the end of the world, not a big problem, but now you need to do a little bit more investigation. So if we see that happen with our sink, let's just say we're doing dishes, we get the pulsation, right? We go downstairs, leave the sink running, go downstairs, listen. Now you can hear that short cycle. The next step is you're going to want to go to the Schrader valve, which is the cap right on top of the tank, and press it, right? Does air come out? Does water come out? If water comes out, boom, answer problem solved. You already know that bladder is ruptured. Next thing you can do is you can knock on the side. A good working pressure tank should ring like a bell when you touch the top of it, and it should make like a more of a thunk sound when you hit the water, right? The other thing that you could consider doing is drain the whole system, shake it, right? If you've emptied the system and there's water in that bladder, you shake it, you'll still hear the water shake around inside of there, right? But now the thing's got to be empty if you're doing that. So what causes a short cycle? The most common issue that can cause a short cycle is a ruptured bladder, right? Inside of that pressure tank, remember, you got your water up top, or sorry, your air up top, water on the bottom, and the bladder in between. Well, on WellXtrol, there's going to be an actual metal plate in the middle that has a hole in it about the size of a golf ball. Now, what'll happen is if the air pressure in the top gets too low, that bladder will constantly rub on that hole, and then you run the risk of that bladder popping on you. When that happens, you can't fix it. You just replace the tank. It's kind of like with a leaking water heater. If your water heater's leaking, it's time to replace that thing and start over, right? The other, a little bit less common issue could be corrosion on the springs or the contact plates itself, right? So if you're not able to get a good solid connection between the house power and the pump power, that'll also cause it not to cycle correctly. It usually kind of makes a couple more weird sounds and it acts a little bit different. So it's not super common, but it does happen. So usually the easiest way is to check the tank first, see if the tank's the problem. If the tank's fine, then you move on to, is it the switch? Is it something else? What else might be going on? But it's almost always the tank or the pressure switch itself that causes a short cycle. Now, a short cycle will cause a shorter lifespan of your well pump. So it's super important that if you do find this, that you make sure you get it addressed, you deal with it as quick as you can. Well tanks aren't cheap, but it's part of home ownership. You want to make sure you take care of your equipment so that everything's playing nice, working the way it's supposed to, and you get it addressed. So if you like content like this, if you thought I had some value to you, please hit that subscribe button. I have more information posted every day on the world of Well and Septic. If you have any questions, comments, or concerns, leave them below. I try to respond to everybody as fast as I can. Till next time, guys.